Hi, everyone. My name is Kevin Miller, and I'm the Director of Strategic Partnerships for Microsoft's Justice Reform Initiative. The Justice Reform Initiative at Microsoft sits in our Tech and Corporate Responsibility Group, and we partner with national and community-based organizations to advance fairness and equity in the criminal legal system. With me as guests today are elected District Attorney John Kellner of Colorado's 18th Judicial District, his Senior Deputy Chief District Attorney Chris Wilcox, and Dr. Don Steeman, Chair of the Loyola University of Chicago Criminal Justice Department and Co-Director of the Prosecutorial Performance Indicators Initiative, which is what we're here to talk about today. So since we began working on justice reform in approximately 2017, we've learned that supporting access to data-driven insights through the use of Power BI can have a transformational impact on our partners' ability to drive change and ground what are often highly complex and contentious conversations in data and evidence. So today you'll hear from Dr. Don Steeman on some of the prosecution work he's leading across the country, and you'll also hear from our two prosecutors about how Power BI is transforming the way their offices work. So Don, let's start with you. Can you just give us a brief overview of prosecutorial performance indicators and the work that you're doing across the country?
The Prosecutorial Performance Indicators Project is a partnership between researchers at Loyola University Chicago, Florida International University, and the University of Massachusetts, and prosecutors' offices from around the country. The project started 6 years ago with an initial group of four offices where we started to develop a set of performance indicators for prosecutors' offices. And the goal was to move beyond traditional measures of prosecutorial performance and rather work with prosecutors' offices to think more broadly about what prosecutors do and to measure their performance in new ways.
Can you tell us a little bit about how the Colorado DAs and the Colorado District Attorney's Council are using Power BI specifically as part of the PPI initiative?
I think for a lot of offices, and Colorado's not unique in this way, a lot of prosecutors' offices don't know a lot about the number of cases that they file or the kinds of outcomes that they're getting for cases. So one of the first things we wanted to do was to work with offices to build a dashboard that would allow them to access some very simple information, right? So exactly about how many cases they had filed, what types of cases they had filed, what kind of outcomes they were getting for the cases that they were prosecuting, and whether there were differences in those outcomes across different defendant groups or across different victim communities. So what we did was try to build a dashboard that would allow them to look at those cases more clearly.
Great. Thank you so much, Don. DA Kellner, I'd like to turn to you now. So as the elected DA in the 18th, can you tell us a little bit about how your office is using Power BI and the value that you and your staff are getting from having access to data-driven insights in your office generally?
Yeah, I appreciate the question. Just to level set for anybody who's watching this, just a little bit about the district. First of all, in Colorado, the 18th Judicial District, my district is the largest, most populated judicial district in the entire state. So we've got over 1.1 million people. We're covering over four counties, a very large space, and 20 plus police agencies that report to our office that send cases for filing and charges. And then, of course, within such a large judicial district, we've got just over a dozen mayors and city councils that want to know what's going on in their communities, that have people in their communities asking them questions. And of course, they filter to us in the justice system. And we want to give them reliable, accessible information about what's happening in the justice system. So, we started using Power BI for internal reporting. And that was really important for me when I took office. I wanted to be an open and transparent office to help build better trust in the justice system and in the important work that we do as prosecutors.
How has Power BI and the data work that you all are doing improved your ability to engage with communities?
Yeah, the response so far from communities has been just incredibly positive. Since I've been elected, basically numbers and data are part of every conversation I have with the public. I do quarterly town halls, and every single one of them includes a data update. What are we seeing and what are the numbers behind it? Folks do not want to have a justice system that is so important in their lives and their communities that's driven by anecdote. They really do want to know that you're making decisions based off of what's actually happening and not just what somebody might be perceiving on a one or two person off basis. It's based off of real information.
Great. Thank you, DA Kellner. Chris, I'm going to move over to you. So as a member of an office in a in a space that is relatively non-technical, and I'm talking about the prosecution space writ large, not your office specifically, but what's the journey from development to deployment been like for you and your team with respect to the Power BI work?
Absolutely. So as you mentioned, Kevin, I've got a legal background. I have no degree in anything technical. And we have really good technical staff here, but they were all hired to do technical support related functions or network administration. We don't have a data scientist. We don't have anybody with that skill set. And so when we first started looking at how do we answer some really basic questions and things that were really simple, those were questions we really couldn't answer. We didn't have access to the data. We didn't have a way to really process it and use it in a way that was meaningful. And so in our first step, we ultimately went with just the free desktop Power BI client, right? And we were able to get access to some of the tables that are housed in our case management system. But that was essentially it. That was the guardrails we had. And so from there, it was myself and some other folks that were committed to finding out more about these details in our office using Power BI and essentially clicking around and seeing what worked.
Can you tell us just a little bit about some of the dashboards you've created or specific metrics you're tracking that have been, sort of most useful in terms of how work or business processes have shifted in your office?
That's a great question. I think it depends a lot on what unit you might come from. So we have in a larger office, we've got a diversion unit and we've got a diversion director. We've got a juvenile chief who handles all of our underage juvenile cases, right? And so we would get entirely different questions depending on what the area of law somebody was coming from. And using Power BI, we were able to basically check a box and say, okay, we just want to look at juveniles now and push that data out to the folks that needed to make a decision there. But it's, a lot of it's been just a process of discovery. Now, one of the things that we discovered going through this process with Don was that while we still have work to do collecting basic demographics on defendants, but we were doing a horrible job of collecting demographic information about our victims to understand, are certain communities being victimized at a greater rate than they probably should be? And how do we understand that and process that as an office? And so we were able to identify, look, we've got a data gap here. There's a question we want to understand. And we were able to go to our victim witness director, that unit, and sit down with them and say, here's what we're seeing in the data and here's this hole. And they just turned that directly into action and immediately changed some office processes on that so that we're gathering that information better and we're allowing those victims to have a voice in that process.
District Attorney Kellner, Chris, you all have these dashboards now. You've seen some impact from them. Where do you take this work from here? What's next?
I'll tell you this, Kevin. The disparity analysis was really eye-opening in a few ways. If you ask somebody, how do you define justice? And you're going to get all kinds of different answers, probably different answers from everybody on this panel. And I like to think that justice is a fair process that leads to a fair result. And, a lot of times it's not measured in numbers. You know it when you see it. But there is a way to look at data for large macro trends and say, does this fit with my concept of what justice should be in our community? And one of the things we saw was that, we've got some disparities, especially when it comes to our Hispanic community.
I think John hit it exactly right. Next step in the knowledge for us, I think, is where we can go in terms of prosecutors on the ground. From the management side of things, a lot of what John touched on and Don touched on, it's about targeting that resource. We have a limited number of prosecutors, a limited number of judges in courtrooms, and we want to make the most of the cases that are most important to our community. And so this is really helping us target those efforts and divert or dispose of as efficiently as we can the cases that are maybe not as serious and focus on the crimes that are most impacting our communities.
Great. Thank you so much. Listen, I continue to be inspired by the work that's being done in Colorado, by the work that Prosecutorial Performance Indicators is doing. It just goes to show, I think, the sort of burgeoning demand and understanding of the power of data and Power BI as a tool for using this data in the prosecution space. It's something that we at Microsoft continue to be excited about. Thank you all for being here. For anyone who would like to learn more about Microsoft's Justice Reform Initiative, you can visit our website at microsoft.com/JRI. And thank you for tuning in.